Good morning. In this video, I am going to discuss how we can sort the elements of an array by using the bubble sort. First of all, we must know what we understand by bubble sort. For example, if we have five elements, first of all, we have to compare first with the second and then maintain its position, then second with the third and third with the fourth, and up to the last. After that, we have to start with the next elements and do the same. Right? Here, I have already written the code. I'll explain how it works. First of all, I took an array of type integer in which the size, maximum size given is a 5. Here I'll enter the element. This statement will just write display on your screen that enter the elements. After that, I'm using scene statement to give input in an array. Here I start the index from 0 up to 5. It means I am going to store 5 values in this one. Let us suppose I have stored 3, 56, 77, 8, and 99. Next is what? In a bubble sort, it works like a bubbles. First of all, I'll compare 3 with the 56. The very first thing, it is up to me. I can convert my elements into a ascending order or descending order. For this, I just have to change less than or greater than sign. Right? Now, first of all, I'll compare these two, 3 and 56. If 3 is greater than 56, then what it will do? It will change its positions. Otherwise, it is not going to change anywhere position. But here, 3 is not greater than 56, therefore it will not. Then it works on here, then to here, it will change the position because 77 is what is greater than 8. Okay, after that, what 77 and 99, it will remain the same. Right, now look at here in my code. I'm doing the same thing here. First of all, I'm using the integer I as an initializer, I less than 5, I plus plus. It will do what? It will do what? It will do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Means it will give 5 passes to my code to sort the elements. Right? Now here I'm using what? For int j equals to 0 means I'm stretching what? The first element, that is 3. J is less than 5 minus 1. 5 minus 1 means what? J is less than 4 minus I. Minus I means 0. It means it is what? It is 4 when the first pass is there. Okay, it is 4 when the first pass is there. It means J is less than, you can say that, 4. Now, what will happen? Firstly, A of J means what? A of J means here the J's value is 0. And this value is 1. It means here what is there? 3. Here what is there? That is 56. 3 is greater than 56. This is not true. Therefore, this operation is not going to be held. Right? It means it will retain its position. Right? It will goes here. Again, it goes inside a for loop because until unless this is not going to be false, it is not going to for a outer loop. Now, next attempt, your j is what? Your next attempt, your j's value is 1. And what is your this condition? J is less than 5 minus 1 minus I. I is always same. Okay, I is always same. Until unless this is not going to be false. Therefore, your j here is less than 4. This is also true. Now, it will go inside a of j. Now, a of j is what? A of 1. This one 56. A of j plus 1. This is 77. Okay, 56 is greater than 77. No, again it will retain its position. It will come here, come here. Now your J's value is incremented to, okay, J less than 4. This is again true. It will go inside here. A of 2. A of 2 means what? Now the 77 and A of J plus 1 is A of 3. It has 8. This is true. 77 is greater than 8. Therefore, it will do this swap operation and it will interchange the values. Now, in this pass, what will happen? Here, have now 3, 56, 8, 77 and 99. Right? Now, next time, J is what? 3. This is less than 4. This is true. Therefore, here it goes. A of 3, A of 3, that is 77, is greater than A of 4. A of 4 is what? This one. This is not true. Therefore, it will go here and here. Now, the J's value becomes what? 4. Here, J is less than 4. Here, it is false. Now, what happened after first pass? We will get this as a output, right? It goes here, here, again it goes here. Now, I is what? I becomes now 1. I becomes what? 1. Okay, now here, J again starts from 0. It again, you can say, takes this one. Okay, now, J is less than 5 minus 1, that is 4 minus I. Now, the I is what? Next time, 1. Therefore, this becomes what? 3. This becomes what? 3, right? J is 0. This becomes 3. Firstly, it is true. It goes inside and again it do the operations. Again, it do the operation and you have to go for 5 number of passes. After that, you will get your sorted element list, right? After that, what happened? After these all passes, what will happen? You just have to traverse your array list and it is in a sorted order. If you still have any query, please do comment. You please write like this, only then you can understand how this code works, right? I'm compiling my code, running my code, like I'm writing element 12, 3, 45, 7, 99, and you will get output 3, 7, 12, 45, and 99, right? And if you want it to be the other order, then you can use here less than, save, compiled, run 12, 3, 67, 5, 88. Now you will get 88, 65, 12, 5, and 3. So you are getting in a descending order. Okay, before that you are getting your elements in a ascending order. It is up to you. You can also write more things here. You can also write if somebody is entering the double values, then what will happen. If somebody is giving a negative value, then what will happen. You can also assign a size here. Ki user has to enter the size, how many elements he want to enter. This is your task. You have to do this. Still, you have any query, do comment. Thank you very much for watching.